Hey guys, this is John with GreenFish Nation. I want to welcome you to my channel today, Bass Fishing with GreenFish Nation on YouTube. Guys, this is my Perception 11.5 kayak. I've done a lot of modifications on it, but today mainly we're going to be talking about the motor I've added, the steering system I've built, and the PWM that I've constructed. So you guys stay tuned for more information on these modifications right here on GreenFish Nation. All right, guys, we're back. We're going to talk about our motor. First of all, I decided on my motor that I wanted a transom mount motor versus a bow mount motor. Everything I've bought here has actually came off of Amazon. You can actually get all of these parts and pieces. And if you'll look right down there in that description, I will link every piece of equipment that I have bought to modify this kayak, the name and also the part number from Amazon, so you guys will be able to repeat this exactly if you'd like. First thing I did is I bought myself a Minn Kota 30 pound trolling motor for propulsion. Then I bought you have to have some way to steer it, so I bought a steering control, I guess you would say. You got to have some way to mount your trolling motor, so I bought this transom mount. I went up inside of this transom mount with just a black piece of cutting board, just a PVC cutting board, and I used that on the back side underneath. That way I've got a good solid mount for my transom. And then I decided I didn't want to be reaching behind me, steering it with a pole or steering it with my feet. I didn't want anything in my deck space there where I fish. I wanted all that clear and open, but I also wanted to be able to move right back here to where my black pack is. I carry 9 rods on my black pack. I don't want anything hampering any of that. So I devised a system here to where you can do that, keep your back deck space clear and your front deck space clear. Also wanted to be able to raise and lower my motor from my seat to be able to lock it into position. If I'm fishing somewhere where it's a little too shallow for a motor, I want to get my paddle out and paddle. I can do that, and I'll show you right here next on GreenFish Nation. All right, guys, in order for me to be able to do what I wanted, raise and lower my motor, I had to figure out a system of ropes and pulleys that would allow me to do that from my seat. So, as you can see here, I have some actual kayak pulleys, and again, all of these things will be down in the description there at the bottom, and some carabiners, and some, I can't remember what these are called, but they're little connectors that you use on your kayak, the little rope loops, I guess you would call them. But anyway, those will be in the description as well. But in order to make this work, you need 2 pulleys. You need 3 carabiners. You need a little bit of 3/8 climbing rope. Also, you're gonna need about, 4 of the loop connectors for your pulleys to connect to. 2 rope stops, about 6 inches of PVC pipe. That should get you fixed up. And it's as simple as this. This first rope actually locks the trolling motor in place. So you pull it through the rope stop and it actually locks back here. It locks this in place. That way your motor doesn't move up or down. Okay. Real important piece back here is a little piece of bungee cord with a zip tie. And that, what that does is that keeps your motor unlocked at all times. So to unlock it, you're just going to pull up and it's going to unlock your motor. All right, now to raise your motor, you're just going to pull up on your rope. And if you want to set it at a certain height, you just lower it to that height. Even if you want to keep it in the water a little bit, just pull it through and lock it in place. And there you are. That does your locking in place and stuff. If you want to lock it in place wherever you're at using your reverse lock, you can do that as well. But that's not really necessary with this rope lock. And this thing is pretty solid. It's not going to slip. You can do all this from your seat. To get it out, all you do is pick up on it and lower it down, okay? All right, guys, next we're going to move over to the steering system. So y'all stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. All right, guys, as I said, I wanted to keep my deck space clean because I got big old size 15 feet. I also carry a black pack with 9 rods back here. I did not want to interfere with that any way, shape, form, or fashion, or my tackle storage. So I come up with this unique little steering box. Works great. And you can build it for less than $10. All right, guys, let me first explain to you before we get into the working of the steering box exactly how this works. Again, I have the rope connectors. I have 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those, okay? I also have 4 kayak pulleys. Again, those are down in the description. You can find those at Amazon. When I crisscross my lines, you can do it anywhere in route from A to B, and it'll make your boat work correctly. When I turn my handle to the right, my boat goes to the right. When I turn it to the left, my boat goes to the left. Guys, if you're liking our content so far and you haven't subscribed to our channel, just click right down there on that subscribe button. It'll get you hooked up. Be sure you turn on those notifications so you'll get notified when we release a video. And don't forget to give us a thumbs up. It helps our channel, our algorithm, and we really appreciate you guys. All right, guys, in order to control my kayak's speed and direction forward and reverse, I added a PWM, which is a pulse wave monitor. Picked this up at Amazon as well. Again, that part's going to be down there in the description. So here it goes. Pulse wave monitor control for my kayak. Guys, this is a real simple build as well. I just went to a local dollar store. I picked up a little Tupperware dish. I like it because it's sealed around the edges. Pulse wave monitor, PWM, is right here. You just have to make sure you hook up your wires to your battery and to your motor in the proper order. I just took a little Dremel tool and I cut, drilled a hole here with a drill bit, cut little squares here and here, and then I added this lithium battery monitor so I know how much power I have, and that just simply snaps on there. You got forward and reverse, so forward, and then you just click it on, and then you can see the motor run. That's high, and then you can adjust it to any level in between that. I really like the pulse wave monitor. I'm really glad I done that. It makes life so much simpler. Also, it saves you on battery consumption. Unlike your regular trolling motor head, I see a lot of guys doing that, and that's totally fine if that's what you want to do, but I want to make you aware of something. Your battery's 12 volts. When you turn that thing to 1 on this Minn Kota, it puts a certain percentage to the motor itself, and the rest of it turns into heat and dissipates out into the water. It's constantly using the 12 volts, okay? When you put it to 5, it's 100% going to the motor and no loss to heat. So you're using your battery faster that way. With this pulse wave monitor, it works in pulses, so you get a little pulse, and it happens so fast, it's milliseconds. You guys watch here and I'll show you the prop. So this is the prop, this is off, and then I turn it on, and I mean, I can control it. That you can see the minute little pulses. But you give me a trolling motor controller that'll turn your motor that slow. And then as you turn the dial forward, you get more speed. And that's full speed right there. At full speed right there, guys, I'm getting about 3.5 miles an hour with me and all of my equipment in the kayak. I weigh 330 pounds, I'm 6'7", so I'm a full grown man. And this thing, it pushes pretty well. You can use this in a windy situation, like if you're, you know, wanting to fish into the wind, kind of like a spot lock, I guess, but you know, it's not actually gonna lock you in place, but I mean, you can kind of control where you're setting with some really fine tuned adjustments. Also, if you're fishing in a river or a stream and you got a little bit of current, you could adjust that thing to where you could kind of sit in one spot. I think this is gonna be a real handy item here, guys. All right, guys, we're gonna get into the inner workings of the steering box here. Just takes a cordless drill. You're not gonna believe how simple this is and how effective it is on that motor. It's amazing. When I first took this kayak out, I could not believe how it performed. All right, guys, let's get into the inner workings of this box. I'm gonna try to get you guys right on it. As you can see, I've got a half inch PVC pipe cap here, and it's not even glued, it's just slid on. I've got a half inch by half inch 90 or an elbow for PVC. I didn't glue this, I just drilled it, tapped it, put a screw in it. And I've done the same thing here on the back for my control lever that goes through. But let's get inside the box. Four screws will get you inside the box. I chose to use paracord over steering cable because I know I can be off somewhere fishing and need a piece of paracord, and more than likely somebody's got it. Tell you what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna loosen this off and I'm gonna pull this out of here. This is sealed and it's watertight. Inside this box, you're gonna see that I simply drilled a hole in the bottom of that box just so my PVC pipe right here will fit down through into that hole. Kind of acts like a bearing without a bearing. This is a 3-inch by 3/4 inch bushing. You can get that at your local hardware store. I put that onto a 2-inch to 3-inch bushing. I used a set screw here and a set screw here. And to attach my rope, I simply drilled a hole in the front, run my paracord through, and then I screwed a screw through both of those fittings into this PVC pipe just to keep everything rigid and from moving. And it's real simple. You just put that in place, put your screws back in your box. This is like a 10-minute build for this little box. It's literally a 4-inch junction box for electrical connections. It comes in gray. I just painted it to match my kayak because I like the color of it. It's got about 5 coats of paint on it. And then right here on the front, just to help stabilize everything, I added a piece of paracord onto my Yak Attack paddle holder. That stabilizes everything. Guys, I hope this answers your questions about the steering, the box, and how I've got it set up. It works great. I love it. I can't believe I haven't done it sooner. Guys, I have a ton of modifications on this kayak, and I'd love to share each and every one of them with you. So I'm probably going to do several different videos. So again, subscribe to that channel and you can learn how we've done the modifications on our kayak. Leave us a comment, share something that you've done on yours that you don't see on ours that you think we might like. I've got a custom battery box build that I'm going to do a modification video on. I've got a custom camera pole that I built. I'll do one on it as well. I do have dual cameras on this kayak, one in front and one in back, using the Yolo Tech poles. But I wanted to be able to do a little adjusting and things if I want to swing my camera arm around, get a head-on picture up close, or lay it down in the water releasing a fish or whatever. I wanted the freedom to do that, so I built a custom pole for that. Guys, y'all stay tuned to Greenfish Nation. I appreciate you joining us. Go ahead and drop us that subscribe button. I know you want to know about these other modifications that we have. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish all you guys tight lines.